Living Seed Media brings to you God's Word, which is His comprehensive equipment for changing lives. May the Lord impact your heart as you encounter His Word. For further inquiry or counsel, contact Peace House, P.O. Box 971, Boko, Benue State, Nigeria. Telephone numbers 0703-036-3659, 0703-768-1198. Email address lsmedia@livingseed.org or visit our website at www.livingseed.org. Let us sit back and listen as the servant of God brings forth the word of life.
Let us pray together. Our Father and our God, we thank you this day. Thank you for your faithfulness. Thank you for your loving kindness. Thank you for calling us into the ministry. Thank you for your wisdom that has again allowed that we, your servants, will gather for these few days of retreat. Lord Jesus, our one cry to you that we want to see you. We want to see you. Want to see you lifted up in our midst. Want to see you glorified in our midst. We have come together. The Bible said the gathering of his people shall be unto the Lord. Father, to you we have come. We have not gathered to a man, we have gathered to you who understands. Reach out to each one of us. Amen. Do for us what we cannot do for ourselves. Amen. Let the Holy Ghost come down. Amen. Let him renew and rekindle our fires. Amen. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Thank you, Lord, for hearing us. As we start this meeting tonight, we are praying that your presence will overwhelm us. Amen. Meet us at our point of need. Do for us what we cannot do for ourselves. Amen. And at the end, oh God, take all the glory. Amen. In Jesus' name, we are prayed. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I would like to thank the Lord for the opportunity that he has given to me to be able to come to share fellowship together with us. Because only God could have made that possible. I also want to thank our fathers in the Lord who have made this meeting possible. When some of our pastors came to Boko 2 years ago, and we met, they said, we need a meeting like this among our pastors, at least in Lagos. But it was looking very difficult at the time. I said, let us pray about it. And we kept also praying and they kept checking. Several calls, they sent different brothers and people. But it wasn't possible throughout last year. But as we were praying and trusting God, we saw that it can be possible this year. And I was requesting that whatever it is, they should see how we can organize ourselves. And it was only in January that we could see this little space. and that is why I do not take your coming for granted. I know you have adjusted and squeezed yourself to be here. I know it is not very convenient. I know it is because you honor the Lord.
The
Bible said, those who honor me, I will honor them. God will honor you in the name of Jesus Christ. Whatever adjustment you make to be here, God will do much more than this for you. The Lord Himself will manifest Himself in our midst. I also want to appreciate our fathers in the Lord. Even though they have not heard me preach like this before, they did not say we don't know Him. They believed the brothers, the pastors that came. Say, okay, let's bring him in here. Because you know there are many, many wolves in the sheep's skin. There are people that have sugar-coated mouth and they will come and speak big, big things. And they may just only scatter the flock. I would like to appreciate your faith. And I trust that God Himself will bless you. And that our relationship that is beginning now, God will bless it. God will bring revival to His church under your hands. God is going to increase the work in the CAC. The revival that started this church, it was a very great revival that affected many, many people. And the way God has kept it going, because it's something that came from God. Now that you are the one on stage, you do not die in your hands. You do not become an empty noise in your
hands.
God is going to spread the fire. And the Holy Spirit will continue to watch that heritage. Because there was an heritage that God planted in the church. There is a body in the heart of our founding fathers. There was something they saw in God. Themselves to this. And I don't think God is going to look away from me. The cry of our heart is that God will visit us again. Now, as I look at the theme of our meeting, an approved minister of God, and the welcome remarks that our Father in the Lord brought to
us,
it is very clear that this, any local church, whether it will be on fire or it will die out, completely depends on the minister. If a church will have a vision to move forward, it depends on the eyes of the leader. If the leader has no vision, the people under his hand will perish. Because the Bible says, where there is no vision,
they will perish. Nibi ti iranko ba ti si awon eyan sege.
So this night,
ni asale yi,
I would like us to start looking at our theme text.
Ami asale ma fe ke koko ma wo ese bibeli ti a yan gan.
An approved minister of God.
Iranse Olorun to yege.
What does God look for before he can approve a man for his ministry? What does God concentrate upon before he can approve a man and put a stamp of approval on his life? Many people rise up and call themselves something. Some will look for one big title for themselves. And they may be trying to work. But when God has not approved them, they will soon fizzle out. So we are going to be praying together, studying the word of God. What does God look for to approve a man? And how must we prepare our own lives that the divine approval on our lives will not be taken away? I would like us to turn our Bibles together to 2 Timothy, which we have said we are going to study.
Mo fe ki gbogbo ajo sibele asinu we Timothy keji ti a so pe a fe gbe yewo yi.
2 Timothy chapter 2 is what we wanted to study.
Timothy keji ori keji ni a fe se ayewo re.
And verse 15 is where our theme had been taken.
Ese kedogun ni a ti wa mu koko oro jade.
But you know, when you want to study the word of God, you don't just take one verse like that out of context. The Bible passage has been located in a context. We cannot understand it unless we know what it said before. And we cannot interpret it properly if we don't know what is following after. So, in order for us to have a proper understanding of our theme this month, I will request that we will read the book of 2 Timothy. If it were possible to read it from chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3, chapter 4, it will have been very good. But you see, there's no time for that. Even though as we will start studying the Bible, we will refer to all of these chapters. Do you know why? That letter is to one man. God was sending an instruction to a minister. God was preparing Timothy to become an approved man and an effective man of God. There is a lot of instruction for any servant of God in this letter. And I would like to spend a bit of time this evening just to lay a general foundation. So that when we come back tomorrow, we will begin to build on this instruction. And we shall be praying that God Himself will open His word to us. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So permit me to ask us to read 2 Timothy. We will read chapter 2. Just to read the scripture. And then we shall go ahead. Let's read from verse 14. And I will read it to verse 26. Of these things, you want to read in Yoruba language so that you just read, or can I read in English? I can read in English. Okay. Of these things, put them in remembrance, charging them before the Lord that they strive not about words to no profit, but to the subverting of the hearers. Study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needed not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. But shun profane and vain babblings, for they will increase unto more ungodliness, and their word will eat as doth a canker, of whom is Imenaeus and Philetus, who concerning the truth have erred, saying that the resurrection is past already, and overthrow the faith of some. Nevertheless, the foundation of God standeth sure, having this seal: the Lord knoweth them that are his. And let everyone that names the name of Christ depart from iniquity. But in a great house there are not only vessels of gold and of silver, but also of wood and of earth, some to honor and some to dishonor. If a man therefore purge himself from this, he shall be a vessel unto honor, sanctified and meet for the master's use, and prepared unto every good work. Flee also youthful lust, but follow righteousness, faith, charity, peace with them that call on the Lord out of a pure heart. But foolish and unlearned questions avoid, knowing that they do gender strikes. And the servant of the Lord must not strive, but be gentle unto all men, apt to teach, patient, in meekness instructing those that oppose themselves, if God peradventure will give them repentance to the acknowledging of the truth, and that they may recover themselves out of the snare of the devil, who are taken captive by him at his will. May the Lord bless his word to our hearts as we study together, in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen. Now, like I said, this is a personal instruction that Paul, an apostle of Jesus Christ, by the will of God, sent to Timothy, his dearly beloved son in the Lord.
Paul, see, Omar, and Inuolua, Timothy.
Now, when Paul met Timothy in one of his missionary journeys, he told Timothy to come along to follow him. So while Paul, the apostle, is preaching the gospel, Paul was following him.
Timothy was following him,
and he was helping. He may carry his bag, he may help him with his clothes or whatever. He was training him in discipleship, or what you call an apprenticeship, for ministry. You know that when we started CAC, for example, those that were fathers in the Lord, they never travel alone. You will know that they will pick some young people whom they believe that God is going to use to follow them.
ọ̀dọ́mọkùnrin tí wọ́n wà gbọ́gbọ́ ọlọ́run yóò lò láti lè máa tẹ̀lé wọn káàkiri.
You know that for some time when the servant of God is praying, these young people that they have carried, they are either waiting or praying or running errands for them.
Nígbà tí àwọn bàbá ń gbàgbọ́ ní ìgbà náà, àwọn ọ̀dọ́mọkùnrin tí wọ́n kó káàkiri wọ̀nyí, wọ́n dúró láàání ẹ̀gbùlé àbí kí wọ́n máa jíṣẹ́ káàkiri fáwọn bàbá.
Some of our fathers here,
ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ náà bàbá tó jókòó níwájú yìí,
they were apprentices under such men of God.
Wọ́n ti jẹ́ túlẹ̀ tàbí ọmọ ẹ̀yìn lọ́dọ̀ àwọn bàbá àgbà tí ó ti kọjá lọ́mọ yìí.
Am I correct?
Ṣé bẹ́ẹ̀ ni?
But you see in our days,
ṣùgbọ́n ẹni pé ní ayé tá a wà lónìí,
many young people just want to man start their own mountain.
Àwọn ọ̀dọ́ kan bá ti jáde báyìí, wọ́n fẹ́ lọ dá orí òkè tiwọn sílẹ̀ ni.
If they have a small vision like this,
ṣọba ti ní ìran kékeré tí ò tiẹ̀ tí ìrìn náà dáadáa,
they will quickly call themselves apostles.
Wọ́n sọ pé pèrè àwọn ní apostoli.
I'm going to start something.
Wọ́n sáré obìnrin kankan.
To the extent that you don't even know where he is coming from.
Tó débi pé àtẹ̀ ní mọ pé polele ti já wá báyìí.
One of the first issues that we saw in the life of the men that God approved for ministry in those days.
Ọ̀kan nínú ti àkọ́kọ́ rí nínú ayé àwọn tí Ọlọ́run yàn tó yege ní ìgbà náà fún iṣẹ́ ìránṣẹ́.
Is that they were people that stayed under teaching.
Ó jẹ́ pé àwọn jẹ́ àwọn tó dúró lábẹ́ ìkọ́ni.
They were people that God took time to train them under the hands of men that he has prepared.
Wọ́n jẹ́ àwọn tí Ọlọ́run wá àyè láti kọ́ wọn dáadáa lábẹ́ àwọn Ọlọ́run ti lù lóde.
You see, the matter of discipleship or the matter of apprenticeship under a senior or an experienced servant of God was something that was common in the Word of God.
Nínú Bíbélì, láti kọ́kọ́ ṣe túlẹ̀ lábẹ́ àgbà ìránṣẹ́ Ọlọ́run, ó jẹ́ ohun tí a máa ń rí dáadáa níbẹ̀.
It's only in our time that people think it is too much to learn the way of ministry under an elder.
Ṣùgbọ́n ní àkókò tiwa ìlàrí pé ó dà lójú àwọn ọ̀dọ́ tó dìde bẹ́ẹ̀ni pé eléyìí nira ju kàlẹ́ káyọ̀ tó máa kẹ́kọ̀ọ́ lábẹ́ àgbà ìránṣẹ́ Ọlọ́run.
Even though there may be Bible school.
Bí ó lè jẹ́ pé ilé ẹ̀kọ́ Bíbélì wà.
But we still knew that time.
A sì mọ̀ pé ní ìgbà náà.
That what makes a man of God is more than Bible school.
Pé ohun tó máa ń sọ yìí ní ìránṣẹ́ Ọlọ́run ó kọjá pé a lọ sí ilé ẹ̀kọ́ Bíbélì.
Even before you are recommended to Bible school in those days.
Láyé ẹjọ́ ọ̀kọ́jẹ́ tó fún ọ níwèé pé lọ kẹ́kọ̀ọ́ Bíbélì.
This man has stayed under the hand of a leader.
Irú ẹni bẹ́ẹ̀ á ti kọ́kọ́ ṣe túlẹ̀ lábẹ́ àwọn bàbá àgbààgbà náà.
And they have watched his life.
Wọ́n á lè ti wo ìgbésí ayé rẹ̀ dáadáa.
And they can confirm the call of God on his
life. Wọ́n á lè wẹ́ nítorí òótọ́ Ọlọ́run pè léyìí.
And it's not because he has money to pay his school fees in the school.
Kì í ṣe torí pé ó ti lówó tó fi sanwó ẹ̀kọ́ Bíbélì.
It is that the men of God said, this one can go like that.
Ṣùgbọ́n torí pé àwọn àgbà ìránṣẹ́ náà ti rí pé eléyìí lọ ẹjọ́ lọ ilé ẹ̀kọ́ Bíbélì.
So we noticed that the relationship between Timothy and Paul was that of a senior minister or a father in the Lord to a son in the Lord whom he is interested in becoming a man that God can use.
Ohun tí a wá rí nínú ayé Paulu àti Timothy náà ni bẹ́ẹ̀ ìrìn àjò wọn, ó jẹ́ ti ìrìn àjò pápá nínú Olúwa torí ọmọkùnrin kékeré kan tó pé eléyìí tó bá tẹ̀síwájú Ọlọ́run yóò lù ú lóòótẹ́ òyege.
Now, so while we are looking at this,
nítorí náà pápá ti ń gbé eléyìí yẹ̀wò,
there are several things that brother Paul was pointing out to Timothy that is preparing him to that verse 15 that we are going to talk about.
Ṣé a máa wá wo bí ìdájọ́ àárín pé arákùnrin Paul ó ní àwọn nǹkan kan tó ń sọ fún ọmọ rẹ̀ yìí pé àwọn nǹkan báyìí lórí láti ṣe kí o tó lè di ẹni tí ó yege.
Before I come to introduce the verse 15.
Kí n tó wá sọ fún wa nípa ẹsẹ̀ kẹ́ẹ̀ẹ́dógún yìí.
There are several issues that we want to quickly highlight before we go.
Àwọn oríṣiríṣi àwọn kankan wà tá a gbúdọ̀ kọ́kọ́ sọ náà kà tó wá lọ sẹ́sẹ̀ kẹ́ẹ̀ẹ́dógún.
In chapter 1 verse 5.
Nínú orí kìíní ẹsẹ̀ ìkárùn-ún.
Paul said, I call to remembrance the unfeigned faith that is in you, which dwelt first in your grandmother Lois and your mother Eunice, and I am persuaded that it is in you also.
Paul sọ fún Timothy pé nígbà tí mo bá rántí ìgbàgbọ́ àìṣẹ̀tàn ti nbe ninu re eyi to ti koko wa ninu loide iya na re ati ninu ibike iya re.
Now most ministry does not start with any man.
Ise ese ki ibe latodo emi kan so.
The first thing that God looks for,
o to lo koko ma wa,
is your personal conversion.
O na ni igba la okan wo gogo funra re.
When are you converted?
Nigbawo ni o di atumi ni agba ola.
You see, Paul said, I call to remember.
Paul ni mo ranti dada.
The unfeigned faith that is in you.
Igbawo iseta to wa ninu re.
Now, that to me is the first testimony.
Eyi lo wa koko je eri la.
Before you climb on the pulpit,
kí o tó gorí àga ìwà asù,
can we testify?
Ǹjẹ́ a lè jẹ́rìí mi ọ́?
That there is a faith of vain faith.
Pé ìgbàgbọ́ ìṣẹ̀tàn.
Without hypocrisy.
Láì sí àgàbàgebè.
Faith that we can see.
Ìgbàgbọ́ tí a lè fojú rí.
That we can touch.
Tí a lè gbámú.
That we can testify.
Tí a lè sọ nípa rẹ̀.
Faith unfeigned that is in you.
Ìgbàgbọ́ àìṣẹ̀tàn tó wà nínú rẹ.
For Timothy, the prologue said, that faith, I know your grandmother Lois first had it.
Paul sọ fún Timothy pé irú ìgbàgbọ́ tó wà nínú rẹ, mo mọ ìyá ńlá rẹ pé ó wà nínú rẹ.
Even your mother Eunice, I know.
Mo tún mọ ìyá rẹ Eunice náà, ó wà nínú rẹ.
That same faith is in you.
Mo sì gbàgbọ́ pé irú ìgbàgbọ́ yẹn náà tún wà nínú ìwọ náà.
Let me ask.
Ẹ jẹ́ kí n béèrè lọ́wọ́ wa.
Who
Dani
can testify about you?
Tó lè jẹ́rìí pé ìwọ tó dúró yìí.
That your faith had been without hypocrisy.
Pé ìgbàgbọ́ rẹ kò sí àgàbàgebè nínú rẹ.
Who can testify?
Dani ó lè jẹ́rìí pé ọ́.
That your life has been consistently following the word of God.
Bí ìgbé ayé rẹ lẹ́sẹ̀ lẹ́sẹ̀ ló ti ń tẹ̀lé ọ̀rọ̀ Ọlọ́run láti jẹ́ òyìnbó.
The pulpit is not the first place.
Ní orí àga ọ̀rọ̀ àsìkò ló ti ń bẹ̀rẹ̀.
Your private life.
Ìgbé ayé ìkọ̀kọ̀ rẹ là ń sọ nípa rẹ yìí.
Anybody can preach.
Bó ẹnikẹ́ni lè wàásù.
Even the devil preaches.
Èsù náà oníwàásù ni.
But the Bible says.
Ṣùgbọ́n bẹ́ẹ̀ni wípé.
By their fruits.
Nípa ìso wọn.
We will know them.
Láà fi mọ̀ wọ́n.
Paul said, I'm persuaded.
Paul ni mo gbàgbọ́ pé.
That faith is in you.
Irú ìgbàgbọ́ yẹn náà wà nínú rẹ.
And I'm saying, Lord.
Èmi náà wípé Olúwa.
If a man is going to win approval from God.
Bí Ọlọ́run yóò bá fi òǹtẹ̀ oyege lú ènìyàn.
The faith in his life must be unfeigned.
Irú ìgbàgbọ́ tó máa wà nínú rẹ̀, ó gbọ́dọ̀ jẹ́ ìgbàgbọ́ tí ò ní àgàbàgebè nínú.
The faith he carries must be without hypocrisy.
Ìgbàgbọ́ tó ń gbé káàkiri kò gbọ́dọ̀ sí àgàbàgebè nínú rẹ̀.
The faith he is carrying must be evident to people.
Ìgbàgbọ́ rẹ̀, ó gbọ́dọ̀ hàn gbangba sí àwọn ènìyàn kó nígbàgbọ́ ni.
His life must be clearly the one that has been converted.
Irú ìgbé ayé rẹ̀ a gbúdọ̀ ní nítòótọ́ pé eléyìí ti di àtúrí.
If a man of God.
Bí ènìyàn Ọlọ́run.
Does not have the testimony for his life.
Tí ò bá ní ẹ̀rí fún ayé ètò fúnrara rẹ̀.
There is no way he can go far.
Kò sí bó ṣe lè rìn jìnnà.
There is no way he can hide behind the pulpit.
Kò sí bó ṣe lè sá pamọ́ sẹ́yìn àga wàásù.
So the first question that we saw in this passage.
Ìbéèrè àkọ́kọ́ tá a rí nínú ẹsẹ̀ bíbélì yìí.
Was that brother Paul was saying.
O ní pé arákùnrin bá Pọ́ọ̀lù wípé.
I remember.
Mo rántí.
The kind of faith that is in you.
Irú ìgbàgbọ́ tó wà nínú rẹ yìí.
That there is no hypocrisy there.
Pé kò sí àgàbàgebè nínú rẹ.
There is no àyínnìkè there.
Kò sí àyínnìkè nínú ìgbàgbọ́ rẹ.
We can know that your life is straightforward.
Àrígbé ìgbé ayé rẹ ó tọ̀ tààrà.
So can I ask a question before I go?
Ṣé mo lè béèrè gẹ́gẹ́ tó máa tẹ̀síwájú?
Is there a testimony?
Ǹjẹ́ ẹ̀rí ti ẹ̀ wà?
About your faith.
Nípa irú ìgbàgbọ́ tó wà nínú rẹ.
About your personal experience of God.
Nípa ìrírí rẹ tọ́kẹ́ ti kára rẹ nípa Ọlọ́run.
Is there a testimony?
Ǹjẹ́ ẹ̀rí kankan ti ẹ̀ wà?
That you have been like this.
Pé báyìí ó ti jẹ́ tipẹ́.
You know, there are some preachers. When you see them on the book, and they are preaching, some people at the back of the church, they are laughing. Why are you not taking this man's message seriously? He said, you don't know him.
Hey, that for me.
What is he talking?
Kilo sorry.
Why are they doing that?
Kilo na tapi mboche.
They know something.
No man kaka.
And the rest of us don't know.
Tell you your man.
They say, when did he become an anointed man of God? When he was in the choir the other time.
When he was the one there, the other.
Was he not the one who predicted the girl? Now he
say
he's a man of God.
But what's about the national by you?
Is there a testimony?
In
where people used to know you.
Tia, when we come on your team, tell them.
There are people that when we want to discipline them from this local church, because their life is not correct, they will travel. Go to another place. When we started praying there,
they
begin
to
head like this. And they are filled with the Holy
Ghost.
The first approval that God was confirmed. Did he have a faith that is of faith? Is his faith the one without hypocrisy? Can people around testify that he's a child of God? Can they say with all their hearts that this man, he's a man of God? That was the first thing we saw, that Paul was speaking about concerning Timothy. Hallelujah.
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 But before I go away, I want you to quickly follow
me.
Go with me to chapter 2. We are not going to read from verse 1, verse 2, because I will come back on that later on.
He said
in verse 4, no man that worried entangles himself with the affairs of his life, that he may please him who has chosen him to be a soldier. And he said, and if a man also strive for mastery, yet is he not crowned except he strive lawfully. Thank you. Now, the next point I'm saying that Paul was confronting Timothy with.
Oh, okay.
Said, if there's any man that God will have approved, but he has entangled himself with affairs of this life, he cannot please him who has appointed him. And he said, a man cannot win a crown when he did not run according to the rule of the game. So he was noting two issues there. That for a man to be approved of God, he must not be entangled with the things of this life. He must not be entangled with the things things of the flesh. He must not be entangled with the things that has entangled men in the world. And if he is going to win at last, he must not cut corners. His life must not be the one that is cutting corners. Then he said to me, consider what I'm telling you. God will give you understanding. So I was wondering why Paul was insisting on this young man. He was saying, look, if you want God to approve you, if you want God to use you, from entanglement? Have you released yourself from all the traps and trappings of this world? Or you think there's a shortcut to the anointing? Or are you imagining that you can cut corners and God will still use you for a great work? Why will we be praying to God tonight? You see, I am not just talking about what everybody can see. I'm talking about something in your secret life. Something that people don't know you are still doing. People don't know you are cutting corners. They don't know that you are not straightforward. They don't know that your life is not like you are saying it. God wanted to do a new thing. God wants to walk a new walk. God wants to release power again. God wants to move like he moved before. You don't know what God did with our father. You don't make noise before God walks. But now, you are doing many things. Nothing. What is the matter? Have you checked your private life? Are you not entangled? Are you free? Are you free? You see, this meeting is only for ministers. We did not allow church members to join us. Because we need to talk to God by ourselves. We need to pray together. This church must not die out of our own hands. The power of God that this church is known with must not dissipate. But God is now asking, the men I want to approve, is their faith of faith? Are they unentangled? Are they not cutting corners? What they say they are. What attracted God to our fathers that made them to confirm their word, that when they speak, people honest their word. People are crying everywhere. That will come back a whole village. They didn't have posters. They don't use their photographs. But God was gathering people for them. What did God see in them? Their hearts were so simple. You know that many of them, They did great works. But yet, they did not have anything to do with money. Many of them, all they desire is that the power of God will rest on them. Whether they have money in their pocket or not, that is not their
matter.
They serve God with their heart. They did not care whether a big man was in the congregation or not. They spoke the word of God without fear. Those that are not ready to repent, they rebuke them.
Jimo mo bere lowo yin bayi
have you not got God's
share ti ma fe ku die die kun bayi
and you straight for God
so she do lo ni esere
what God is looking for
o ta lo run reti
does he find it in you and me
je o ri ninu emi ati eyin
are you not eager to make money out of the ministry
share se tori owo na lo je je gule gule le mi share
are you not breaking God's word because you want to have something
so ti ma fa oro olodun ya bayi tori ko fe
what exactly is the matter with your life?
Give me wahala to deba ye gan ni to den.
Lord is saying,
Olorun wi pe
in this meeting,
ninu ibade yi
that he has desire for us to meet.
Pe o ni awon gbede keke to fe ki a tele o.
Can we genuinely say to God,
she a le so ni waju Olorun ni to jo,
do something with my life.
Olorun afaye mi se bo ti wo,
do something definite with me.
Oluwa faye mi dara kankan pelu mi.
Lord,
Oluwa,
don't allow me to go from here.
Ma je ki lo jade nibi yi
without a touch of your power.
Lai tamu agbara le mi
without a release of your power.
Lai tu agbara re lu mi.
Am I communicating?
Je mo ba yin soro.
Yes,
je mo soro.
We want to talk to God by ourselves.
A fe ba baba wa soro funa wa.
We don't intend just to do as if we're doing ceremony.
Ah, what are you talking about? Yeah, yeah, maybe.
Some of us have left all our works.
Oh, well, I'm glad you come with us. Well,
to serve God.
That is your Lord.
So, what are we going to get?
Kill our vendor.
If we cut corners.
Stop at my face. We say,
Kupewa.
It will not profit us.
Kupewa.
It doesn't profit us at all.
Kupewa.
It doesn't profit us. If you are going to eat the frog,
it only you like
it. Eat the fatted one.
To ba je pe ise ila la fe fori la fe run parun sese.
If you are going to squeeze all we have, all our energy to this work,
that ni kan da konkon ni kankan.
I will not have any other thing in the corner.
Agodo be re fagara Olorun.
We must ask for the power of the Lord.
Oluwa.
Lord.
Iṣẹ́ tó fẹ́ fàyè mi ṣe.
The power the work you want to do with my life.
Ara tó fẹ́ fàyè mi dá.
The design you want to do through my life.
Ìran tó ní nípa tèmi.
The vision you have concerning me.
Iṣẹ́ tó fẹ́ gbé mi ṣe nù ayé.
The work you want to do through me.
Kò gbọ́dọ̀ bọ́ mọ́ mi lọ́wọ́.
It must not fall off my hands.
Mo kò bá sí wa.
If there's anything
tó ń yẹ ojú Ọlọ́run kú lára.
That is removing my your eyes from me.
Tí o jẹ́ kí Ọlọ́run kọ́ gbájúmọ̀ wá ṣe wá lórí.
That is not allowing God to face us and bless us. We must pray about it today. The Lord, lay your hand upon me.
Every hindrance
that does not allow you to use
me,
remove them from my life. Don't separate me from
them.
Let them not make me a
non-entity.
Let no sin cut me short.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So Timothy.
Timothy.
Paul confronted him.
Paul, who did you call?
Now, look at what Paul was confronting him with.
See what Paul? What did Paul make I want you?
He said in verse 15.
Oh, we near said,
study to show yourself approved unto God.
Sharp and lati fi ara re han niwaju Olorun.
You know, tabaka ni a se ba mi ka ye.
If you read it the way I have just read it in Yoruba language,
you know it in Yoruba that they pe won ni kokawo.
If you read it in English, it seems as if it says, study, go and read books.
Why would we call it a degree?
You will think it means go and get more degrees. But I want to remind you, our fathers whom the Lord used,
degree,
how many degrees did they get? The anointing is not based on the number of degrees you get.
So when we
still saw that verse, they are not saying struggle.
Do your best.
Sharpen.
Work hard.
Shisha taku taku.
Be diligent.
Murakari olodu isha.
So we got approval for you. That's the matter I want to raise before we pray. When God has approved a man, he does not need to run around. He does not need to beg men to hear him. He does not bribe people to come to his meeting. Because God has approved it. God has lifted him up and said, this man is my servant. Go and hear him. Go and listen to him. Now listen, sir. The Bible says, do your best to win God's approval. If you want to do anything,
say,
go and win God's approval. Rather than begging human beings, rather than doing kobe around
people,
why don't you go to where God approves his
people?
Why don't you go back to God?
Lord,
what are you looking for? That you cannot use. What have you not seen that is not letting you release your power? What have I omitted that is making you to withdraw your hand?
Go on, why are you just looking at me like this? I am getting old. And my years are going back. All the promises you made,
now
they have been fulfilled. Lord, what are you looking for in my life? What else do I have to do? What do you want me to do?
Paul
told Timothy that struggle.
You know another word for sharp man? Tiraka.
The other word for struggle is make extra efforts.
Tiraka.
Make extra efforts.
But tomorrow,
face this word.
But tomorrow,
concentrate on this word.
Oh, let your word hang tomorrow.
You cannot handle this word with levity.
No,
if you want to be approved of me, the person that God can use, that God can put his glory upon him, that God can place his work
for,
that God can pour his power upon,
it
is not something you hold with levity.
It
is not something you just sit and say, hey, if it come, let it come.
He told Timothy
that struggle, make extra efforts.
I'm not that Bible verse say, she I
see me. Don't go at rest at all.
Yes. She I see me.
Don't go resting. So that God can accept you as an approved workman.
As I go back to that scripture verse
15.
Don't need to show yourself. But if you are reading from NIV, is there NIV Bible verse here? Let me read it quickly, sir. Present yourself.
Present
yourself to God. Stop presenting yourself to human beings. They have nothing to give. They may clap for you because they don't know you. They may call you a big name because they don't know how empty your life is. They may do as if you are a big man.
What about the way you are?
When heaven is still querying your life.
Sometimes
when a man come up to preach. And the people clap for
him.
If you ever hear what God says. Where is he coming from? Who has put this man here?
That don't fear any CB.
As he said, the problem with his wife. What is he coming here to say? Immediately.
No,
you see how God will close the chapter. He may now be speaking. God is not interested. Excuse me, sir. Let's not finish this retreat. The way you came. You know, only you know. What is happening? You know where the shoe is pinching. You know it.
Oh man.
You know it.
Oh man.
You know the matter that is in between you and the Almighty God.
Eli Buruma. Oh man. Oh man. Oh
man. You know it.
Oh man.
The Holy Ghost is pointing at a matter. Do you know that some of you used to have the anointing on your head before?
But
it has dried.
She got it better now.
And you know what you fell
out.
You know what you did. And the Spirit of God withdrew from you. If we don't cry to God. If we don't confront this matter, how many years are we going to be struggling on the
pulpit?
Say, do your best. If there's anything to do during these 2 days, forget everybody. Let's face God. God, what is it that you must deal with for me to move forward? Don't let me be stagnant. You will stop on this for tonight. But note there are two words there. Do your best.
Sharp on tirakagidi
to present yourself.
Not the fiara
to God.
Ni what you oluwa.
Present yourself.
Fiara
to God.
Ni what you oluwa.
With whom there is no shadow of turning.
Ni bitiko siet rara ni be. Kosi agida ida.
Where even in the dark he sees. Even in obscurity where nobody sees.
Baba
sees.
Baba
he knows. And he said, why is he behaving as if I don't know
him?
Why is he going up and down as if he has no case to settle with me? Why are they inviting you to the pulpit and you agree when you know there's an unfinished matter between you and the Lord.
Kí ló fà á náà mi fi wọ́n pé ọmọ wa máa sùn wọlé gorí àga wa sùn lọ ó sì mọ̀ pé ọ̀rọ̀ ń bẹ ẹjọ́ ń bẹ láàrin ìwà tó lọ́hùn tẹ̀ tí ì parí.
Why did you get confidence to come and be speaking?
Kí ló fà á tó fi ní ìgboyà tó fi gbórí gbóyà láti wá máa sọ̀rọ̀.
When you know that your heart is dry.
Tó sì mọ̀ pé ọkàn rẹ ó ti gbẹ.
Is it because the church is now lukewarm? That's why you are doing like that.
Ṣé torí pé ìjọ ti di kòkòrò tútù ló fi ń ṣe bẹ́ẹ̀?
Do you know years ago?
Ǹjẹ́ mo pé ní ọ̀pọ̀ ọdún sẹ́yìn?
If a man of God is not in the spirit.
Bí ènìyàn Ọlọ́run ò bá sí nínú ẹ̀mí.
He is very afraid to come near the altar.
Ẹ̀rọ a máa bà á láti súnmọ́ pẹpẹ Olúwa.
You know why?
Kí ló fà á?
He is not sure whether there will be no prophecy in the congregation.
Ẹ̀rọ a máa bà á pé tí o máa dédé dé bí pẹpẹ tẹ́lẹ̀ kan tó pé gbọ́ ọ̀rọ̀ Olúwa tó wá tú àṣírí rẹ̀ jáde.
You know in those days.
Ẹ̀rù pé ní àwọn ọjọ́ àná.
There are people in the congregation.
Àwọn kan wà láàrín ìjọ.
That when we start praying.
Bí ẹ dábàá ti bẹ̀rẹ̀ sí ń dàdúrà.
Suddenly we say this. Don't say the Lord.
Ẹ̀yin gbọ́pẹ́ gbọ́ ọ̀rọ̀ Olúwa.
Arákùnrin.
This man.
But now.
Ṣùgbọ́n nísìnyí.
You have killed all of that.
Ẹ ti pa gbogbo ìyẹn nù.
The people that are prophesying for you now.
Àwọn tó ń sọ tẹ́lẹ̀ fún ọba yìí.
Then the one two three, you have settled them.
Ẹ ti parí iṣẹ́ pẹ̀lú àwọn ọmọ yẹn.
They only speak to assault you against your point.
Ṣé náà kúkú ń sọ̀rọ̀ láti gbé ọ lẹ́sẹ̀? Èyí lọ jáìsí all the time.
Are you sure that can take you to heaven?
Ṣé ẹ rò pé àwọn ọ̀rọ̀ tí wọ́n sọ ìlú pé yín níjọba Ọlọ́run ni?
Are you sure that will give you what you are looking for?
Ṣé ẹ rò pé ìyẹn máa gbé ọ owó Ọlọ́run fẹ́? Ṣé wọ́n fi lé ọlọ́run?
I want to conclude on this tonight.
Mo fẹ́ parí lórí ẹsẹ̀ yìí lálẹ́ yìí.
Study.
Ṣáàmù.
Do your best.
Tiraka.
Face this matter.
Dojúkọ ọ̀rọ̀ yìí gan-an.
Face it squarely.
Dojúkọ gan-an.
Present yourself to God.
Fi ara rẹ hàn fún Olúwa.
Bring your life before God.
Bí ayé rẹ wá síwájú Olúwa.
Lord.
Olúwa.
Here am I.
Èmi rè.
Here am I.
Èmi rè.
Here am I.
Èmi rè Olúwa.
The struggles of my secret life.
Gbogbo ìjàkadì tí mo ń jà nínú ìkọ̀kọ̀ ayé mi.
The failures I have been having.
Àwọn ìjákulẹ̀ tí mo ti ní nínú ayé mi.
The secret sin that I have been
covering. Gbogbo àwọn ẹ̀ṣẹ̀ ìkọ̀kọ̀ tí mo ń daṣọ bò mọ́lẹ̀.
The quiet compromise I am having.
Àwọn ìgbọ̀jẹ̀gẹ́ ní ìkọ̀kọ̀ tí mo ti ṣe.
The things that has hindered you from working with my
God. Àwọn ọ̀gá tí ò jẹ́ kó lè bá ayé mi rìn.
Settle it with me today.
Olúwa yanjú ẹ̀ pẹ̀lú mi lónìí.
Don't let me go again.
Má jẹ́ kí n padà síbẹ̀ mọ́.
Change my story.
Yí ìtàn ayé mi padà.
You see when God does
it. Sọ́nà wa ti ṣe èyí.
There shall be revival again.
Ìsọjí yóò tún dìde.
There shall be fire again.
Iná yóò tún ràn.
God is going to work again.
Ọmọ náà tún ṣiṣẹ́ lẹ́ẹ̀kan sí.
You know there's a song we used to sing in our church.
Ǹjẹ́ mo gbọ́ orin kan wà tá a máa ń kọ nínú ìjọ wa?
I don't know whether you remember.
Mi mọ̀ bóyá ẹ tún rántí orin yìí mọ́.
That song says.
Orin yìí wí pé.
If you want the Savior.
Tó bá fẹ́ olùgbàlánì.
To work with you.
Pé kó bá orin.
From morning to evening.
Láti àárọ̀ títí di ìrọ̀lẹ́.
There is a rule.
Ìlànà kan ti wà.
That each day you must follow.
Tó gbúdọ̀ tẹ̀lé lójoojúmọ́.
Humble yourself.
Rẹ ara rẹ sílẹ̀.
To work with God.
Láti bá Ọlọ́run rìn.
Ìwọ bá ń fẹ́ kólúgbàlálà tọrù. Kò bá ọ rí pátókúrọ̀ ti dálẹ̀. Òfin kan pẹ́ tí wọ́n kò lè ṣàìpamọ́. Rẹ ara rẹ sílẹ̀ olúwa. Rẹ ara rẹ sílẹ̀ fún olúwa rẹ. Rẹ ara rẹ sílẹ̀ fún Ọlọ́run rẹ o. Òun kò lè bá wọn àgbèrà kẹrin. Rẹ ara rẹ sílẹ̀ fún olúwa. the Lord walked with the prophets and sages. He will come now. If you meet his condition,
humble yourself
for God to walk with
you.
This is not what we can be looking at one another's face. Sin is not in anybody's face. God was saying to
Samuel,
look not at his face. Look not at his countenance. Don't look at the height of his stature. I, the Lord, I have redeemed him.
Motiko,
why?
Gilofa,
I have looked into his heart.
Motiwo kare,
and it's not correct.
Kudepi kubi.
If we're going to win approval tonight,
bi ala yola lu alu teo yeke lale yi.
He will look not at how you dress.
Koni wo lu ashato wo.
He will look at your heart.
Yo wo kare.
Where are you, sir?
Oluwa, arakore.
Where are you, mama?
Oluwa, mama.
Where are you,
bolewa?
Where do you stand?
Oloduosi.
What is God looking at?
Kilolorunwo.
That you have not settled with God.
Toti yanju pelu Olorun.
We stop on that matter tonight.
Amado lori ese ilale yi.
So that we can pray together.
Ka le gbadua papo.
So that we can seek God's face together.
Ki a le wa di Oluwa papo.
So that whatever we can say to God.
Ki ohun ko ta ba le ri so si Olorun ni asale yi.
On this altar.
Lori pepe yi.
Let's thank God.
E je ka tete ya so.
Let's thank God.
E je ka tete so.
You have brought me into the ministry.
Oluwa iwo lo pe mise ranse ranse.
Not to disgrace me.
Ije ko jule ti mi.
But this thing that has crept into my life.
Sugbon yi to wa lo aye mi yi.
Please deal with it for me.
Oluwa mi yanju e.
Please put your finger on it for me.
Oluwa dawo le loni.
Don't let me become a mere ridicule on the pulpit.
Ma je ki di ene ye ye lori pepe.
Don't let Satan just push me about.
My yaki satan yo come at me kakiri.
Do something new in my life.
Oluwa se otutulaye mi.
Do something new in my life.
Oluwa se otutulaye mi.
He said, please put away empty talk.
Oni mu awon oro were kuro ni enu re.
Yes. Short, profane, and vain babbling.
Mu awon oro aluwa shapu kuro ni enu re.
That's not what we need.
Ki se awon kan ta fe po ni wonyi.
Face the reality of your own life.
Don't you pay gangan bayi.
Some people have missed it.
Awon kan ti si.
They went up and down like Philetus and Hymenus.
Wa so ka ki ni Philetus and Hymenus.
They have made mistake concerning the word of God.
Wa ti si asi so nipa oro Olorun.
I see many of them on the pulpit.
Mo ri opolopo lori pepe.
Some have thrown away their wives.
Awon kan ti le yawo won lo.
And they are still preaching.
Won dey si waasu.
Some have regulated their church secretary.
I want to the former akobe ijomo loyun.
They are still shouting.
What is it by lori pepe?
Some they are using alubaida.
Awon kan lo magic.
As if that is the anointing.
Many be iyen ni ifaberoro yan.
Some are going back to herbalists.
Awon kan ti to baba lawo lo.
To collect aworo.
Láti lọ gba ohun tó máa gbé èrò wá.
I need to look at see oh, they are popular.
Bẹ́ àwọn ọ̀dà bẹ̀rẹ̀ pé wọ́n jẹ́ ẹ̀rẹ̀ṣẹ̀ Ọlọ́run gidi.
Nevertheless.
Síbẹ̀síbẹ̀.
God knows those that belong to.
Ọlọ́run mọ àwọn tó ń sìn ín, ó mọ àwọn èèyàn tirẹ̀.
They let every man that name the name of Christ.
Ó ní kí ẹnikẹ́ni tó bá gbé orúkọ Jésù.
Depart.
Kó yàgò.
From iniquity.
Kúrò nínú ẹ̀ṣẹ̀.
When we start again tomorrow.
Bí a bá ti bẹ̀rẹ̀ ní ọ̀la.
We will be looking at where God looks.
A fẹ́ wo kí lọ́lọ́run wò gan kí lọ́lọ́run wá.
To approve a man.
Kó tó lè fi oúnjẹ lu ènìyàn kan.
Where does God look?
Apá àgbọ̀dọ̀ Ọlọ́run wò.
And if God is looking at the heart.
Ṣé mo máa ń wo ọkàn ní tòótọ́?
And I am looking at appearance.
Mo sì máa ń wo aṣọ tí èèyàn wọ̀.
You know I'm making a mistake.
Ẹ bí mo ti ṣì í bẹ́yẹn.
If God is looking at the secret place of a man's life.
Bí Ọlọ́run máa ń wo ìgbésí ayé ìkọ̀kọ̀ ènìyàn.
And I'm looking at his performance on the outside.
Èmi ni àwọn ọmọ ṣe ń bẹ́ sókè bẹ́ sọ̀rọ̀ níwájú àwọn ènìyàn.
You know I'm making a terrible mistake.
Ẹgbẹ́ àṣìṣe ńlá ni èyí.
So brothers.
Ẹ̀yin ará.
Servant of God.
Ẹ̀yin ẹṣin Ọlọ́run.
I humble myself before you.
Mo re ara mi sile niwaju yin.
But the matter is more than that.
Ṣugbọn oro yi koja be ti ro.
You need to settle a matter with God tonight.
E lati yanju oro pelu Olorun.
You need to go where God approves him.
O ni lati lo, lati lo gba onte Olorun.
Jesus did not get into the ministry.
Jesus ko dede da wonu ise imese.
Until God was ready to approve him.
O ni gba ti Oluwa to fi onte lu.
God was watching him.
Yes, Olorun wo.
Until God can approve him.
Titi ni wa Olorun le fun telu.
May the Lord.
Ki Oluwa
walk in our midst this night.
Ki ore na ni wa ni asale yi.
May the Holy Spirit.
Ki emi mimo.
Who cannot.
Eni ti o le.
Lose his power.
Sisu agbara re no.
May he walk in our midst.
Ki o le na ni wa ni asale yi.
May he do what nobody can do for
him. Ki o le se o ten ke ni o le se fun o.
May the Holy Spirit.
Ki emi mimo.
Kí
o lè já iṣẹ́ ìránṣẹ́ rẹ̀ gbà lọ́wọ́ àwọn tó ń gbé e sálọ
mi lọ́wọ́. May you not be lost in it.
O ní sọ̀rọ̀ níwájú rẹ̀.
May the pulpit where God has put you may not become an empty place.
Ó gbàdúrà pé àga wàásùtọ́lọ́ wa gbẹ́ka wájú rẹ̀ kó má di òtúbáńjẹ́ lásán.
May Satan not tear your garment of ministry.
Ó gbàdúrà pé Satan ò ní fa aṣọ iṣẹ́ ìránṣẹ́ rẹ̀ ya.
May the secret sin the devil is sponsoring around you may he not finish you. Let's go to God in prayer. Anyhow you would like to pray.
Ọ̀nà tó bá wù ọ́ tó fẹ́ dàgbà tó àyè.
When you want to pray in your local language.
Bóyá o fẹ́ gbà lédè ìlú rẹ ni.
Your local dialect.
Tàbí ní èdè ìlú rẹ gangan.
Kò sí ìtọ́nà ọ̀gọ́.
Ọ̀gọ́ ló understand all languages.
Let God hear your voice.
O jẹ́ kó ló wá gbóhùn rẹ.
Let God hear what you are saying.
Jẹ́ kó ló ń gbọ́ nǹkan tó fẹ́ sọ.
Thank God.
Sọ fún Olúwa.
Don't pass me by.
Olúwa má ṣe kọjá mi.
As you are helping someone else.
Tó o bá ń gbà tẹlòmíràn ní àṣálẹ̀.
Help my life tonight.
Olúwa ràn mí náà lọ́wọ́ lálẹ́
yìí. As you are changing somebody's life.
Bí o ṣe rí ayé àwọn tó gbọdọ̀ lálẹ́
yìí. As you are changing their ministry.
Bí o ṣe rí iṣẹ́ ẹsẹ̀ wọn padà ní àṣálẹ̀ yìí.
Do something to my
church. Ṣé nǹkan sí iṣẹ́ ẹsẹ̀ tèmi náà?
I was not good in where I came.
Bí o gbọdọ̀ lọ bí mo ti wá Olúwa.
Do something with my life.
Ṣé wọ́n àgbà ṣe sọ́rọ̀ mi?
Set me on fire.
Olúwa dáná rẹ sínú mi.
Set me on fire.
Olúwa dáná rẹ sínú mi.
Do a new thing with my
soul. Ṣòtítù nínú ayé mi Olúwa.
Lord.
Olúwa.
Don't let me waste away.
Má jẹ́ kí n ṣòfò dànù.
Ẹgbàdúrà.
Pray.
For this meeting to close tonight.
Kí n tó gba àdúrà láti kásẹ̀ ètò ìnílẹ̀ ní àṣálẹ̀ yìí.
I see the Lord standing in our midst.
Mo rí Olúwa tó dúró ní àárín wa.
I see the Lord stretching forth his hand.
Mo rí Olúwa tó náwó rẹ̀ jáde.
I see God bringing the hand of restoration and power.
Mo rí Olúwa tó mú ọwọ́ ẹ̀mú padà bọ̀ sípò tó nà án jáde.
I see him saying come.
Mo rí tó wípé máa bọ̀.
Let's settle the issue.
Jẹ́ ká parí ọ̀rọ̀ yìí.
Let's settle the matter.
Jẹ́ ká yanjú ọ̀rọ̀ tó wà nílẹ̀.
I have not finished with you.
Mi ò tí ì parí pẹ̀lú rẹ̀.
I have not finished what I want to do with you.
Mi ò tí ì parí ohun tí mo fẹ́ fi ayé rẹ ṣe.
What Satan has done, I'm going to correct it.
Ohun tí Satan ti ṣe, mo fẹ́ ṣí padà báyìí.
I'm going to set that matter.
Mo fẹ́ ṣe èyí ní àṣálẹ̀ yìí.
There's a blood in my hand.
Ọwọ́ ẹ̀jẹ̀ tí ó wà ní ọwọ́ mi.
And it's a blood that speaks better things than that of Abel.
Ọ ẹ̀jẹ̀ tó ń sọ tó dára ju ẹ̀jẹ̀ Abel lọ.
When I see the blood, I will pass
by. Tí mo bá ti rí ẹ̀jẹ̀ náà, n ó rí ọkọ já.
I will forgive, I will cleanse.
Mo máa dáríjì, mo sì máa wẹ̀ ọmọ.
But you must come to me.
Ṣùgbọ́n gbọ́dọ̀ tọ̀ mí wá.
Come, let's settle the
matter. Wá jẹ́ ká parí ọ̀rọ̀ yìí.
As we will pray now.
Bí a ti gbàgbọ́ báyìí.
Those who need to a touch of God.
Àwọn tó ń fẹ́ ìdáwọ́lé Ọlọ́run látòkè wá.
Those who know they cannot hide again.
Àwọn tó mọ̀ pé kò sí bí àṣà sí mọ́.
They know they can only come to God.
Wọ́n mọ̀ pé kò sọ́nà mẹ́rin tó kọ́ tọ Ọlọ́run wá.
There is nobody that is looking at us here.
Kò sẹ́ni tó wò wá níbí.
Our church members are not here.
Àwọn ọmọ ìjọba òkùnkùn sí bí.
We can settle the matter with
you. A lè yanjú ọ̀rọ̀ ìpẹ̀bù Ọlọ́run.
You will lift up your hand to God.
Ó na owó rẹ sókè sí Olúwa.
And tell God.
Ó sọ fún Olúwa pé.
Èmi ni o.
It is right, it is hard.
Èmi ni o.
I am the one.
Ojú sí mi mo ṣàánú fún
mi. Lord come to me and have mercy on me.
Ṣàánú fún mi.
Lord have mercy on me.
Olúwa ṣàánú fún
mi. Lord have mercy on me. You knew where this issue started from. You knew where your heart had fell. Lord, tonight, I come to you tonight. Have mercy on me.
To
my friend, Lord, I love you.
If you are speaking to God from the depth of your heart, just
raise
that right hand before.
The Lord, it is I. I am the one that needs your help, O Lord. I am the one. I am the one, O Lord.
It's
talking about me. This is my issue. Lord, have mercy on me. 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 Lord, have mercy on me.
Lord, have mercy on me.
Like never before.
Amen.
Let revival break forth.
Yeah.
what will affect us and affect our churches. Let it break forth again.
Amen.
Thank you for hearing. Thank you for doing more than we can ask for, imagine. As we meet again tomorrow, please take us further.
Amen.
Speak more to our lives.
Amen.
Thank you for hearing.
Hallelujah.
In Jesus Christ's name, we have prayed.
Living Seed Media brings